fantastic series here, Mark.
It is odd that we haven't seen Rogue or Druid from the Hard yet.
It is Planetod.
It is odd. It's Planetod, yes. There's going to be a Rogue there, man. Maybe it's not Tempo Rogue. Maybe they're trying to conceal something. I'm being very hopeful. Of course, it's going to be there you go, Prince Kalasov immediately with the coin. Starting to compose it.
He seems to be doing a good job at it, but the question is, what do you do to combine with Kalasov on the mulligan? Some people would say you just toss away Swashbuckler here because you'd be rather to find something like a South Sea Captain, and maybe look for a Shadow Step as well, nice and early. Pavel, probably going to throw most of this away. There is the temptation to keep Firefly, of course, because you are going first. It would be very difficult if he had the coin, so I wouldn't be surprised if he just keeps Firefly.
Yep, that looks absolutely fine to me. Sarah Chain Gang, obviously, actually one of the strongest cards in the deck, I would say, after Kalasov has been played. That +1/+1 stat buff on both of the minions does make a huge difference, but as you say, there's really no reason to keep that in this opening hand.
Well, a thought going into this mulligan for both players, though. I mean, it is one of those games where it can be won or lost in the first few turns at this tempo. So I'm not surprised.
And just a little bit late, he's going to say to you, surrender last point style, are you keeping it?
Yeah, with the coin. Yeah, I think you have every reason to keep it.
Yep.
It is fantastic as a swing in this matchup. That's an interesting inclusion, Shadowblade, so we have seen that once already.
Pavel,
yes, so both decks are running the Shadowblade.
Last point of course, play on both sides. Obviously on the coin, we have the advantage of it. We've guaranteed it from turn 4. He's still holding onto that coin. Last point of sight is very important in the mirror. He's often thinking, you've got the mirror, there first. You have a huge advantage moving forward. Last point of sight can actually remove that advantage from your opponent. And actually, make it so that you have the mirror on the board. Last point of sight.
That's one of the ways that Pavel is actually going to be able to swing this game back in his favour. He's maybe getting the first button down. So, with Surrender having both colours up and the coin to Pavel's coin, everything's looking up for him at the moment.
Yep, he's still got Swashbuckler to pull out patches, which will be 2. Pavel could go for an. I don't know, he's not going to go for an. He could go for an Edward next turn, but it's never going to be.
Keeping something on the board, trying to keep ahead, get as much pressure as possible. You need to really stay as far ahead as you can now. Surrender has the option of pointing out into his satellite chain gang. That does sacrifice coin into his
It has to be tempting. He's still got the ability to bring out patches. He can also dagger up if he goes with that low. He can remove both minions on the board and leave himself with a reasonable board, 2-1 and 1-1. He also gets the card. So that's definitely a tempting play as well. It's better in terms of the fact that it gets to keep the coin. So it's a strike. Not that relevant at the moment, but.
Might help a little bit later, just to push some extra damage in and combine that with paper injection. That is a scary amount of damage coming from your hand. But I like this one, Surrender. Stay ahead of the board by doing so.
This is going to have to be a fight. Don't think Pavel can afford to sit there. Doesn't feel good, but Pavel knows when to save the other.
So I wonder if this is going to be the last one to turn. It's not amazing, but it is quite a swing turn that is available for you.
Definitely a consideration, actually.
I mean, alternatively, you can just play the Chain Gang out right here.
The problem with the Chain Gang is that the Edmund gets a value trade off of one of them, which isn't the end of the world, but you're still summoning 2, 3, 4 minions with Torb. That's a very powerful play for turn 4. Honestly, I don't know which one Surrender's going to go for here.
It's how much you want to keep the coin for actually Bone Mare. Because in theory, you've seen that your opponent is too much threat down. You're ahead on the board already. So you might be able to get a Battle Spine out on turn 6 in conjunction with the Sinister Strike pass.
I also like holding the boss next slide for a little bit later. It would be better if you know, the scale button. team that's been bucked up. Look at that. Kalisev on the top, Pavel. He can play the weapon as well, clear both of these Saturday chain gangs, and then set himself up for a good few turns to come.
I like how Sarandon took the trade as well, and of course, it frees up his next turn if he wants to play the Shadow Blade on his own.
Yep.
But, yeah, with Kalisev now coming, Pavel might feel he needs to play it just to try and get the value competition going with Sarandon and saying, okay, top deck to top deck, I'm going to be drawing minions that are equally the same value as you, as the ones you have. Alternatively, I could try and get some value off of a scale blade, but I don't think I like it.
I think Kalisev and Shadow Blade just seems pretty strong at the moment. You want to get that Kalisev down as early as possible. Turn 5 is already a little bit late, but it's better than having it. And that one would be completely
I just need to find something that can actually activate the Fast Mind Slayer, though. I always need to be set to step forward. I'm going to get back.
This creates a nice power again. It contests everything that Surrender has very nicely. Unfortunately, Surrender now has a lot of tools in his hand. Backstab, Vast Mind Slayer looks very strong.
The fact you've still got the coin next turn for Bonemare as well, that backstab being picked up is absolutely massive for Surrender. Cleans up the board perfectly, you've got a massive swing turn. Your opponent is forced to just probably put a big minion on the board, and then next turn, toss a Bonemare onto something as well.
It's just pretty disgusting.
You don't have a bone marrow in hand, so you might as well say, alright, I'm going to Kevin to get to a bone marrow next to him, but...
He can block it.
Yeah, I mean, you can actually play Kevin and the bone marrow, and all other options are trash, let's be honest.
That can come down very quickly. Obviously, Surrender will expect the Bone Mare now, because he needs to work as hard as he can to clear it. If he plays the Bone Mare, can he clear it? Yes, he can. He can buff up the Swashbuckler, get the value trade with that 5-5, and then trade the 2 minions.
So Surrender's just one-off lethal here, I believe. So Leroy Jack, wait, unless Leroy is buffed. If Leroy is buffed from Kalisev, then I think he has lethal, but I'm not entirely sure.
I don't think it is.
If it was.
I don't think it is.
And so it would be 6, 10, 13 from the Sinister Strike out of the hand. Of course, you've already got something there as well. So instead, you just play this safe, but boy, that's
before
not
next turn.
As well. I mean, this is the worst. I think this is
it. Yeah, this is so cool. Not a game of faster. It's not what he's used to.
It's not. I mean, backstabbing the boss mine certainly looks better on his part, but there's going to still be a decent amount of damage on the board, and there's so much coming out of that hand now from Surrender. So we are going to finally see Evolution drop again here. And this is uncharted territory for them. They have to start playing counter decks.
Or did they just ping a shaman?
Yeah, they could go for something like a shaman. That's for sure. But plenty of damage now for Surrender. And that's going to be 1-0 for the Planet Bomb. So that's the world, a previous world champion, Pavel, knocked out of the competition for today. He is going to have to.
Current
champion, sorry.
You can't say that, Dan.
I mean, he is a world champion.
He'll come for you.
He probably will, yeah. But at least I can watch him lose for once in his life.
Ooh.
Yeah, it happens even to the strongest of men. But now it's going to be time, possibly, for Old Boy to actually get a game of Hearthstone in this tournament.
Well, as you said, it's quite possible that he is there to counter his opponents, but when you're behind in last year of standing, countering just isn't good enough. As you said, Planet Odd are the only team that have lost one series after winning the first game. And that's because winning the first game gives you such a huge advantage. You counter your opponent, they just counter you back and you're back where you started. They would be better off just playing another one of their strongest decks that they believe can sweep. And that's what the Shaman might be. And we did see Frozen sweep with the Shaman yesterday.
Yeah, quite possibly. I think RNG may have lost after winning the first game as well today, so, but it's very rare. It happens very rarely in that series, doesn't it? But yeah, you're completely right. Something that has the sweet potential can be used here. It's not a drastic measure right now, but the fact you're going up against the Tempo Room, which is a very scary thing. They know full well that Tempo Room can just actually go for a 3-0 because they've done it themselves. So they've seen the Shaman from Frozen. Frozen, but Frozen is an absolutely phenomenal player as well. This squad, actually, Evolution, is probably my pick to win the tournament. It was even before I saw the 3-0s.
All right.
Mainly because of that one.
I'll
claim that one.
And it is going to be the Shaman, as anticipated. The second deck in their lineup, which they believe could sweep. If Frozen can get a sweep with this deck, it means they don't need to reveal the third deck list still, which is, I mean, having only revealed two deck lists is impressive at this stage of the competition. But if they can win without revealing more decks again, that's even better.
And realistically, they probably should have revealed more. If we look back to yesterday when Frozen did sweep with the Evolve Shaman, it was a bit of a
There were a few doppelgangers into Evolve, weren't there?
Turn 6, doppelgangster Evolve happened every single turn. Well, turn 5 if you count the coin as well. But certainly, he gave himself those outs. He put himself in those positions where he made sure he wasn't too far behind on the board. For example, he was playing J-Claws early on to make sure he could compete. So maybe we'll see some more play like that.
That's the start, Surrender. How afraid are you of Devolve? I don't mind keeping the Edwin and just going for a nice big 3-mana minion, nice and early.
The answer is you are very scared of Devolve. Devolve is one of the cards that Frozen is probably going to be looking for because of Edwin. That's exactly something he's going to be looking for in the Mulligan. Keeping Maelstrom Portal is also good, A, because of Pirates. Quite often, Swashbuckler into patches is a thing, and Maelstrom is a fantastic way to swing things back into your favour.
Oh, so Strider actually throwing away the Vast Mind Slayer. Obviously decided it's not as important for the Shaman to have that single target removal. And
yep.
He is going to go for a big Edwin.
Pretty good to stop Surrender from running out of control too early.
Alright, Swashbuckler gets picked back up after being thrown away in the Mulligan. Surrender, you could go ahead, drop patches now, start making trades, or you could just put a Firefly down. I don't think there's any way he's using that coin before Edwin.
There is some thought to not even playing the Bloodsail Corsair from that turn from Frozen as well, because he kept the Maelstrom Portal, and he's expecting maybe Swashbuckler into patches to get more value out of the Maelstrom Portal next turn. But
yep.
I really like this, like, just taking the initiative to try and get the tempo early. It's exactly how he was playing yesterday, so I'm unsurprised that he really just wants to get ahead of this one.
Ahead he is, and will remain at least for a little while, even if he just plays his hero power this turn. If he gets a healing totem, that's great, because he gets filled up after the trade. Spell damage is fine, the Maelstrom Portal can be very, very powerful.
It's how big Surrender wants this Edwin to be. Shadow Step.
Now it can be pretty darn big. He just needs to wait one more turn. Swashbuckler, Shadow Step, Swashbuckler, coin, Edwin can't cleave. That's a big boy.
But are you committing too much resources when you are scared of the vault?
The benefit of using the Swashbuckler is that it's still fulfilling its purpose. It's still generating more value to use later on. So although you're using up Shadow Step and the coin, that's it, really. Actually, it's a very nice deal.
At least Frozen can get some appetite to the vault as well, and hope to get at least 2 draws from that. That's going to be really important.
I think he goes for it, though.
Surrender.
Yeah. Swashbuckler, Shadow Step, Swashbuckler, coin, Edwin.
So all you've seen from your opponent is a Bloodsail Corsair and a Melt, and you haven't even seen the Melt before, so you've only seen the Corsair and this Mana Totem. You've seen Frozen has kept something in his hand, so you are pretty scared of the Vault.
Yep, that's true. But then, if Frozen has to pay the Vault, that's 2 of his mana used up. Edwin becomes a random 2-mana minion, which isn't that bad. Swashbuckler becomes this. I don't think it's that bad, and like I said, you don't lose that many resources to doing so. You still gain a lot of matches.
I think the risk is worth it.
Maybe you're even trading matches into the Maelstrom Portal, Shadow Stepping the patches, putting that into the Maelstrom Portal again, and using the dagger for yourself, rather than putting the Maelstrom Portal. Yeah, exactly the same thing you do. That's so sensible, but I actually get some value too if you play Plano Wall to do that.
10-10 Edwin is great. No, he doesn't. He doesn't. Okay, well, there we go. We do have a game on our hands, Falcone.
Well, we may not have a long game on our hands if it continues like this. Surrender's looking pretty happy with himself right now.
That's just how he looks. He's just a big happy guy.
Him and Hoish are kind of similar to me. They don't show that much emotion. But
they're just very pleasant.
Yeah, they are.
Sixo's pleasant, isn't it? In his own way, I guess. I'd invite him over, but silly. Just the once, though.
Oh.
Anymore, and then it's,
he'd beat you a half.
Yes, that's absolutely correct. So Surrender now does have just a pretty nice play here. Just playing Flame Elemental into the SI7 agent. I mean, this 10 damage is going towards us. Surely.
Yeah, I don't think we can get 10
Well, we might do if Frozen can pick up a double.
Yeah.
That's for sure. That is what Frozen is going to be hoping
but
for.
But it's very obvious to Surrender that Frozen hasn't picked one up yet, because it definitely would have been played last turn. And Surrender made that smart play of getting rid of the Maelstrom, of the Mana Factor. While it may have been tempting to get the Swash Frogger the value, as I was originally suggesting, and getting rid of the Mana Factor doesn't really now, to get the Devolve, getting my card fixed up, to get the Devolve, and functions.
One minion being left on the board as well, means that there is no Flame Tongue Totem shenanigans that can happen to clear off this Edwin. Still no Devolve either. This is slowly getting away from Frozen, and maybe Team Evolution, the team that have had all those 3-0 sweeps, maybe they were looking at a 3-0 sweep against them, potentially.
I think that would make a few of the teams quite happy.
Just to see the biggest team.
Getting a taste of their own medicine.
First two with more attacks, but some of the board, though. Another 11 damage. Now we hit this base. Backstab makes this an even easier turn as well.
We are at 17 damage, we're almost there.
So I imagine you just backstab SI. And you should Flame Elemental, sending 10 damage towards space. And then next turn, you can have a Avery Redwood. Or you can fight, of course. But leaving the Flame Tongue is too bad. And now it's switched to Bold.
That's not going to do it. I don't see a single taunt there, do you, Dan?
No, I don't. And Frozen is going to concede because of it. So both decks that we've seen Evolution sweep with have now been taken out of the competition. And finally, we're going to see something revealed that we haven't seen revealed so far in this tournament. Surrender, 2-0 up and one game away from getting a sweep on his own.
That's a pretty incredible performance, especially when you consider the opponents that they've got right now. It's only Old Boy left. He hasn't even had a chance to play. Quite a high-pressure scenario for his first game.
It's his time to shine. Yeah. I mean, we've been speaking about it a lot, saying give Old Boy a chance, let him get out of bed, let him play a game of Hearthstone. Well, now if he wants to win, he has to play three and win three. But what on earth is he going to be bringing? What can just win three games in a row? Potentially Zoo, that is another deck that has that sweep of potential.
Yep, that is exactly the type of deck you would expect to be queued in this situation. Tempo Mage is another one that could potentially just run away with some games. It's not going to be easy for Old Boy, regardless of what he's playing. I can tell you one thing for certain, the deck. We are going to see a deck that we haven't yet seen.
Correct.
They've played all of their revealed cards already. Now it's time to see something that they've got.
And we may be seeing a deck that maybe Old Boy isn't actually meant to be piloting as well. When you look at Zoo, that might be a deck that maybe Pavel or Frozen were expecting to play, and Old Boy is expected to come with these hard, heavy countering decks like maybe something like Quest Mage or Quest Warrior, for example. Instead, now he's forced into a situation where he has to win three games, but it is going to be the Warlock. Whether it's a control lock or a zoo lock remains to be seen, but I would imagine, judging by the rest of this tournament,
looks like it to me. That's good, Dad.
So, Old Boy's going to be hoping to find a Keller's Elf of his own to start up with. Of course, Malkaiser's Imp is really important in this matchup, being able to draw and cycle through your deck, as well as dealing damage with things like Soulfire and other good Dad, of course.
That is very nice, very light.
Well, I mean, doesn't it run like 15 one drops or some stupid this Zoodex.
A lot of Zoodex do.
Yeah, you'd feel pretty hard done by if you didn't find anything, but this is a perfect way to contest an early board from the Tempo Rogue.
Look at this guy, Hobboy can play. He can pull out patches, use the Acer as better to pull out patches. So he uses the Firefly, he ends up with a 2-1 and a 1-2 on the board, and so he ends up with nothing. Yeah. So he surrenders to the patches, which probably points out that's not a good thing.
It isn't, no, it means on turn 4 he can still say play Substitute Captain into patches.
I prefer that on turn 3 for some.
Yeah, usually, I think people do.
I also like to have an extra card.
It does help. Just getting rid of something that's in your deck. But I like your play. I like now Old Boy potentially going for the Aqua Spectrum. But
that's nice.
Like,
he doesn't.
No. He'd rather just get something a little bit bigger on the board. Might want to save that card as well, depending on what he draws next.
Well, next time he wants to play with three of the Omega modules. Shadow Step could be a surrender that's not going to be particularly helpful here. I don't think there's any value in a Shadow Step back to 5 left.
No. I mean, there is value. Theory, but it's not like actual real.
Minuscule amounts of value in Shadow Step. Not enough to ever consider
it. In hardstone terms, it's very little. So that means that probably just going to see Dagger in Surrender, I would have thought. That there are. The thing is, we're going to get to the point in this game, we're going to get to the turn 6s, the turn 7s, and the Bone Mare's going to come into play. Doom Guard's going to come into play. Surrender needs to be looking for the Bar Spine Slayers. They're going to be really important in this matchup. And Old Boy, he's going to be looking for more of those discard mechanics like Soulfire,
Quite honestly, Dagger on turn 2 is the biggest thing. In the
did you say done? Thing or done? Done. Okay. Done. Completely. It's just a natural thing that you see nowadays.
It's just strictly wrong to die.
Well, now there's a little bit of freedom for Old Boy here. I kind of like keeping the coin because I have Doom Guard in hand. And just throwing that out a turn early is going to be so impactful.
Okay.
But at the same time, you're completely right. I mean, coining out Captain here is pretty big. It's a massive tempo swing. But
the thing is, the Captain survives. You've got the Corsair in hand, the Patches survives as well. It's very difficult for Surrender to actually deal with these guys.
Alternatively, you could just mark as a Zim and use the Aqua Spectre in here. It trades pretty nicely. It does mean if you go for the coin into Captain play, you are making your opponent scare about it a little bit. I'm doing this for technical
This is fine too, it's still okay, that's pretty much. I was a bit surprised when it looked like the Void was going to be taken. I was expecting the Void Walker to be buffed up and then the Patches to survive, meaning that the Captain can buff it up next turn. But this works too. Either way, Old Boy has bought, Surrender does not, and you can see how hard Surrender is having to concentrate on. This is not the best hand I've ever seen.
Well, half the time this deck plays itself, and when you actually get draws like this and your hand is just really garbage, you have to think a few turns ahead and say, how am I actually going to win this game? Where are the influential cards that can be able to swing this back in my favor? What do I need to keep? What do I need to get rid of now? There is nothing that he can do to really contest this board right now, except maybe just play Patches, Dagger, and just kill up this Void Walker. That feels horrendous.
It does. But I don't see a play that does it.
Yeah, this is slightly better in the next turn. You can have Salty Captain into Patches, right? So you should be able to get them back into Patches.
So Old Boy can now play the Captain if he wants to, and buffs up the Corsair, allows that to just value trade against the Flame Elemental, and continue hitting base with his other weak minions. Otherwise he can get that map of us down, which would mean next turn he can call out the Doom Guard, start the cards, and the rest of the cards. The problem is with the Imp, is that there's no way of efficiently using all of your mana with the Imp. You can play Flame Imp as well. Coin out Captain, then you can't play the Doom Guard next turn. I guess you could play the Imp and the Cap, but that's not really the game plan. The game plan is to put as much of the game as possible.
Yeah, with that being the case, I imagine that Captain probably just works here. Puts the most pressure possible. Next turn, you do have a you've got it. What the value of the Malphite's implants you've got, but judging by how far ahead you are on the board right now, I don't think you really care too much. For Surrender, he's now got Captain into patches, clear off the 1-2, and of course uses his dagger to kill the 2-1, and at least he's contesting the board.
Yes. Yeah, you're right. Two captains to the board is okay. He could start to tell the switch though, if he wants to. Try and pick up and defile. I'd be very lucky to get exactly the correct one.
I think that would be a nice card to pick up. I think that's more of a desperation play. I don't think that he's that desperate.
No, I'm just trying to think of alternatives.
No,
I mean, I'd have preferred this game.
Yeah, like, those are the kind of things that I was going to get.
Yeah, that is something that you can do. Something that... One of the strategies to playing this rogue deck very well is knowing when to play the shadow stuff. And actually, using it on a really weak minion like the patches is something that most players just won't do.
That Despicable Dreadlord was just massive for Old Boy as well. It made his turn so easy, there was no thought process, because it means he can now just Doomguard next turn. He is in such a comfortable position,
yep,
and pushing so much damage as well.
It's a shame that there was no way of getting him down first, but it doesn't matter too much. Still controlling the board, again, as the Warlock, really bothered about value, bothered about tempo, although that might change things.
Yeah, that might change things now, but you can play out your whole hand here, accepting God, but Malphite is in. Potentially, he needs to buy it. You don't want to discard Kill Set, though. When it's offered, you want to play like that.
Oh, that's better. That's way better than playing the means next turn, Old Boy can play.
Yeah.
Discard that useless Bowman, which is now just a 1-3-2. The rest of his deck looks better than that. Draws two more cards, which will have the stat buff. This is looking much better for Old Boy. Maybe, finally, Evolution can get their way back into this series.
Yeah, this is looking like a win for Old Boy. I have to call it here, which I think you can be pretty safe in doing so. Naturally, for Surrender, you want to just play careful. If you do that, like, you're so far behind. So, searching and digging for something from Squash Burglar, something like a Defile, like you said, would have been pretty nice.
Not bad, though.
Yeah, that's very good.
Yeah. So now Surrender, I suppose, has to...
Surrender? He could surrender.
He could surrender?
Yeah.
I don't think that's what you're doing if you're surrendering. Oh. It's true, though. You can surrender.
Well, probably. Well, he knows. Nothing.
Bowman is still a possibility. That's his next goal.
Yeah, I guess that's one bonus of getting blooded, because at least it's something that the Bowman can potentially target. But just getting these two cards out of the start is absolutely massive.
They're not incredibly powerful, though. And their stats are good for their cost, obviously. They've got a lot of attack on them. But it could have been worse. It's still possible that he wins. It's very unlikely, but possible. It's also still possible there's a Lich King in this deck. Bone Mare into the Lich King could be a
win. Yeah, absolutely. Or just Bone Mare into Bone Mare.
Yeah.
But he needs exactly Bone Mare to stay alive here. Tar Creeper, well.
He survives.
It's not
great, though. This series is a 2-6 that buffs his attack a lot. Yeah, that's some strong.
Yeah, so you tap, probably look for lethal here if you're Old Boy. I like the play from Surrender as well. Like the Tar Creeper, yes, okay, it delayed the inevitable, but this was the best play Surrender could have made if you can try and win this game by putting as much power on the board as possible. Soulfire will finish the game, so Evolution get one on the board. Surrender will not get a 3-0 sweep, but I think he'll be pretty happy with how he does approach the stage today.
Yeah, I mean, you get a huge advantage by just winning the first game in last year of standing. So winning the first two in a row, Evolution, or Old Boy specifically, has to fight really hard to make his way back into this game as Surrender returns to his team, and Hoyt and Zixo are going to decide what deck they want to bring next.
What can they do? So they've got two shots. They're trying to counter this Warlocks, this Zulok. So this is a nice spot to be in.
This is where the counters really do come into play.
Yes, absolutely. Something that a lot of people have been trying to theorize for this event is, how do we counter Temple Rogue and how do we counter Zulok? So Planet Hard, of course, have that Tall Warrior. The Zixo might want to have a go at doing against this Zulok. There are also things we've got to potentially counter it. We've seen Quest Mage here. That's probably not going to be too great.
No, if it was... Oh, maybe. Maybe. If they can get a Frostnova Doomsayer off, that's actually...
I don't think you'd get enough time. I think if it was a natural Freeze Mage, then maybe you'd get a little bit more comfortable. But I imagine Zixo will probably have a go with this Quest Warrior here. A, it doesn't reveal anything about their lineup, and B, it does do pretty well against the Zulok.
I'm still unsure. We'll have to find out in just a moment.
Well, there's so much taunts in there. Zixo plays so aggressively as well. We saw him go up against aggressive decks with Taunt Warrior already. He does things like Dirty Ramp on 2 to make sure he puts himself in a good position. There's Tar Creepers in there, Stable Defenders, of course. And with all the Whirlwind effects, it do have a lot of board clear.
I don't think that Zixo will have to search further than the three of your decks. It is going to be the Warrior, you're absolutely right. Honestly, I think the Warrior and the Mage decent counters to this, so he's got two good shots without even having to show any other decks. It's a very, very good position for Planet Hard. They are definitely in a good spot to take their second win of the series, of the tournament, which would tie them up with Evolution.
Yep.
Would also end in this series at 2-1 score.
Yeah, there'll be a few teams backstage, or probably in that hotel room, praying that this actually does go that way, because it evens everything up at the top of the table. We have a couple of teams where we want 2-1, and it would be nice if all those teams were tied at the top.
Yeah, none of the other teams would want to see Evolution in the series.
Correct. Old Boy still has to come against the wall, and still needs to win 2 more games with the Zulok, but he'll be only 6 zones. Quest Warrior, which he has piloted very well so far.
Yep, and the passing well continues. It's actually good to frame over to be thrown away. Maybe an Azoth's first mate could replace it. It's the signature Zixo move in Quest Warrior. Meanwhile, Old Boy's hand looking pretty good too. 31 drops, as usual.
This is another reason why Zixo's probably queuing up this Quest Warrior as well. He does have Azoth's first mate. He does have the option to try and counter the aggression from his opponent. He was a little bit fortunate yesterday when he did go for the Dirty Rat against the Evolve Shaman. He had the 50-50 for a Sea Giant, and he didn't pull the Sea Giant. He'll be hoping for similar luck today getting into this match.
I'll be thinking really hard about this Mulligan. What is it? What is he considering? Is he considering throwing away the interest and more effective later on when the discard's been picked up? Maybe he wants some more powerful cards, maybe like a Bloodsoaked Corsair or an Icarus Battery. Some of these cards that actually impact the board itself. These 1/3s don't actually do that much straight away.
Yeah, and you're looking for color set as well. You need to get ahead as early as possible on this board. You can't just be patient.
That's
really good.
Yeah. Again, he knows exactly what he's up against. He's seen Zixo piloting this Quest Warrior deck in the previous series of games. So he'll know that he's not against some crazy aggressive Dazzling Pilot Warrior deck.
Some people may, you've got the age-old question of, do you keep the Quest or do you not keep the Quest? I think because of Blood Reaver Gul'dan being in this deck, you have to keep it.
That's what I think it was Darkman who said yesterday. Against Rogue, probably throw it against Rogue. Even against Rogue, you manage to you sometimes need that more power to do those final blows.
Look at this start. Oh boy, there's so much pressure already early on.
With that second
now, you can just go Malfoy's into Soulfire to deal with this 1/4. You're
working as well.
A lot of pressure. And you're, of course, drawing a card as well, getting closer to some of those bigger minions.
This is a very strong start. So, going to be looking for a sleep with the fishes to come in with that Malfoy.
That might be too late.
Yeah.
He's put a Stonial Defender in the way temporarily, but that only absorbs 4 damage. So he's able to take the initiative now and use this Blood Razor. It does mean next turn he has another weapon.
That'll trigger the battle cry and actually kill the entire team. Without having to swing, there's a team out there. That's a nice follow up to Old Boy. What is the tap this time?
Now, because you've seen the Blood Razor, I don't think you've even put this fire point on the board. You know full well how many whirlwind effects are in your opponent's deck, so you know, just keep this back. But, so he's going to have a click in it, of course.
The argument to playing it could be that you know that the, both Valiants and the Firefly currently on the board are all going to die next turn to this Death Rattle. Maybe you think you can play the Firefly and the Flame Elemental, then you actually get a few more minions to stick after that. I don't think it's a...
Well,
I don't think they play it, but it's definitely something to think about.
If he plays both of them here, it forces Zixo to both attack him and then play another Firefly if he wants to clear everything. However, if he hadn't played this, then he only would have just been able to put a stone in the board, and he would have been a more comfortable spot.
I don't think he needs to play the Butterways, I think he can just drop back a line and put them out because that's it. Clears everything except the Firefly and the Flame Elemental. That's fine. He draws a card as well. He's got the Diamond Hatchling to follow up with.
Still leaving 2 damage on the board though, you are only on 12.
That is true. That is true. I haven't considered how low his Zixo's health total is, so maybe he does just hit the face and play the Butterways. Yeah. Okay.
Jam this Doom Girl into the board, but you are going to be able to say goodbye to 2 pretty influential cards.
It's a good follow-up though, and Zixo doesn't actually have any way of reading this Doom Girl. I was wondering in the previous turn, maybe Zixo should attack with the new weapon rather than the old one, meaning that next turn he has access to the whirlwind effect. If he drew an execute here, that would be relevant. He could drop the Acolyte and play out, swing in the weapon to the face, execute the Doom Girl.
It's definitely something worth considering.
Obviously, he's decided he wants to capitalize and swing every single weapon swing in the club.
Wow, Old Boy not taking the Doom Guard here. And actually, looking for it. They're getting a Malkaiser's Imp as well. So, he can go into the Doom Guard if he wants, or he can just play the Ken and then a follow up after that.
I don't think we're going to be dirty around some people. I know Zixo likes the card, but.
Diamond Hatchling is just too strong at this point.
It's going into the. Yeah, okay. Sure. So it means that the council would just trade evenly with the Hatchling if it gets enough to protect the cover. Sorry, Kaliseth, but I think we're saying goodbye to you this time.
Are we? I don't know. I don't know if Old Boy is. Ken is so good because Zixo has so much removal in his hand and so much board play. Ken is a very sticky.
He still has a little bit of left as well. You're right, this is fine.
And of course, chopping down to make sure there's no easy trade made for Zixo either onto the councilman. I like making that trade nice and early.
So, the defender can allow Zixo potentially to larger next turn. Bog, Creeper. Would be tempting. If he can pick up another whirlwind effect, that'd be Cornered Sentry would be great. Though both Blood Razors have been used up, so maybe...
But he's not used the one that's already in his hand, right?
Oh, no, there's one of the boards.
Yeah, you wanted to. So you can save that. But Old Boy's slowly running out of time here.
He is. He's going to get a lot more resources, though, if he does go with the Deep Guard. Maybe pick up Gul'dan, but it's still a few turns early to play it. It's quite scary that this Quest Warrior has actually almost killed Old Boy. It's not even turn 10 yet.
It's Old Boy's just been tapping his life away as well. Yep, I think it's time to pull the trigger. You've just got to try and get ahead on this board and hope that there's no removal from your opponent. It doesn't feel great. Dossing away Kaliseth and speaking of Dreadlord, of course, but. Buffed up minions aren't going to matter too much at this point, and Dreadlord can use another whirlwind effect to draw your opponent more cards with that card.
Oh, that's not what you want, Old Boy.
I think it's not the end of the game.
It's got to
be. When it was painted, something that we could put a burn on to, and rather than do, it's potentially 5 damage to each other.
Zixo is very much on the back foot here. You may just start by putting this acolyte into the man's eye. Maybe picking up a sleep of the fishes would be helpful for him now. He can make that trade thanks to the blood razor, so he gets to draw two cards this turn. Oh, okay, so now he plays the Sentry and the Ravaging Ball as well to clear up the 1-1s, put two big taunts on the board. Okay, now it's the I guess he could swing the white cap after playing the Sentry.
Yep.
He was hoping to sleep the fishes here. Maybe not, actually. These minions are still very healthy. The Bane Bloodhoof would have survived.
Still look for another Sleep of the Fishes here.
You also wouldn't be damaging your own Ravaging Ball if you played it that way.
So both these taunts are going to be taken out, and one damage still left on board.
Yeah, what is a super simple?
Holdsman can attack here. If he was to attack into a Doomguard, or a Saltfire, I think that does it, right? No, okay, 1-2, you are one off. But you can draw into more with the Saltfire and the imp on the board.
Yeah. Yeah, you start by soul-firing the Dirty Rat, I suppose.
You play patches first,
sorry. Yeah. If you draw Doomguard, though, that's... Oh, no, you can't. You play them. Okay.
Play patches first. Soul-fire them for another soul-fire.
Or Captain Greenskin, that'll do it as well. Oh boy, going to tie up the series, beating Zixo's counter. It's all up to Hoy to finish what the name of what a great game.
Yeah, oh boy, pretty well there. And I'm just saying I need to put as much damage as possible, as quick as possible, but not pulling the trigger too early on the Doomguard. I think that was what was important. He played that Cairn first, something that was going to stick around. Maybe some ordering questionability from Zixo there. Maybe he took a little bit more damage than he should have on that turn.
Yeah, he did. I'm pretty certain he doesn't lose anything by swinging the weapon at first and playing the round before or after. It's still the same two interactions, except the councilman would have had less attack because the one-ones would not have been summoned for Old Boy there. And also the Ravaging Ghoul would have taken damage. So I actually... Yeah, I think that was a bit of a mistake.
I'm sure he'll have a reason for it.
Yeah, I'm not like confidently saying, yeah, that was a throw by Zixo, because I know I'll end up being wrong. Yeah. But
if it was anyone else, you'd confidently say.
Oh yeah,
Zixo always got a match.
I wouldn't if it was George Sewell.
He's also someone you wouldn't avoid. 2-2 then, and it's all down to this young man here, Hoy, to try and close out this game. They were 2-0 up on it. But Old Boy, we were saying today might be his day. Two of his teammates, they 3-0'd previously. Well, I guess he's doing the same thing here now.
Just from reverse.
He has the chance. What a reverse sweep in this tournament would be amazing. Standing is something that is fantastic. And maybe we might just see Hoy bringing his zoo as well here.
Oh, yeah. Yep. Okay, there it is. Wow, going to end on the mirror. This is a big surprise to me. I would have expected him to try and encounter with something that would more consistently defeat.
But I think the Quest Warrior was their counter to Zulok, and that was knocked off. So they take their biggest counter first, and then they go for just, a 50-50 in the end. And what an opportunity this is for Old Boy to really make a massive story there going through this group stage.
Old Boy is the least well-known player. He's had recent HCT performances, but he's not quite the big name that obviously Pavel throws in there. This is definitely quite an achievement if he can now take down Hoy as well, get Evolution their third match win.
I imagine this is a formal game for both players. but they will just have a little think-a-doodle about it, I'm sure.
Who is better, Ballard, Reaver, Gul'dan? We haven't actually seen that panel before, but I'm pretty sure that in some of their games that they actually lost with Azuda, they were actually searching for it.
I mean, that's actually quite a big telltale, because Planet Hunter only revealed 28 cards previously, and there are lists that don't show Reaver Gul'dan,
yeah.
But yeah, you are quite correct, uh-oh-ing, because only Reaver has found Kel'Seth, whereas Poi hasn't quite found it just yet.
There's still time. That's not it. No pirates either on Poi's side. No patches, which is a good thing, though he wouldn't mind seeing another pirate as early as possible. I guess he just starts by dropping the flame at the minute that trades nicely with the Voidwalker.
Yeah, his consideration will be, am I coining anything else out? And I think the answer is probably no. But he's also thinking about a few turns ahead. I mean, that coin can come in very much handy later on for maybe coining to Doomguard or Marquise's Imp coin Doomguard, for example.
Yeah, that's true. He doesn't have any 3-drops, so there's nothing that he strictly has to save the coin. He can always just play Flame Imp this turn and play Alkazar's Imp and Acre Spencer Imp this turn if he just needs to cut out.
A 2-0 lead potentially being thrown away against one opponent, knowing that you are the one gladiator as it were.
Certainly some pressure. Poi, again, is more well-known than Oddboy. I think it's fair to say that. He is the big name in this match. He's not going to want to lose this one. He did pick up another one. So he could play the coin this turn if he just wants to put as much on the board as possible. But knowing that Prince Kalasov has been playing, he knows that if he loses the board control, he's going to be playing.
In this tournament, he has already played one Zoom Mirror, and it was against Pfizer, but I guess it wasn't much of a mirror because she had the discard lock rather than the Zoom lock.
Yes, that's that perfectly.
She
did. So, that was probably not a game that Hoy's going to be. Yeah. 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 Oh, that wasn't a good one. Which is fine, it's not great for taking over the board right now, but he's going to have such a great comeback later next to the stat buffs. It's slightly annoying for him that he doesn't have a 4-drop to curve into, but I don't think there's any reason for him to play this one.
I'm going to correct myself as well, it was why he lost to Tiddler in the Zoom era, but he beat on his own.
We're talking about two different Zoom era.
Another Zoom matchup, so he's got a 50-50% record.
Getting our Zeus mixed up. Poi now has his Councilman. He can play it and coin up Firefly if he wants to get that attack buff. It's so, I can't stress this enough, it's so important that Poi keeps board control here. I won't be at all surprised if he just coins up Doomguard next turn.
Yeah, just to try and get ahead, take initiative.
Which is great, especially if old Poi doesn't play anything on turn 4.
Yep.
Which at the moment he can't.
And because he's seen Kel'Seth as well, Poi needs to take those opportunities when they're presented to him.
Yeah.
And I mean, I guess why wouldn't you if there's a Marquise's Imp on the board already? If it survives, then that's going to be massive. So I wonder if Poi's thinking about anything other than Kel'Seth.
It's such a small player. I'm actually going to play out a Firefly, but so we're going to have to wait one additional turn. That's a strong ability, so
immediately. Yeah, what we said about pulling the trigger, I think that was very much the trigger being pulled in. Although Oldboy had to start getting Kel'Seth,
That's good, though. Patches and Firefly. That's quite a lot of stats that it could.
Yeah, if it was just the patches, it would have been fantastic. But now at least he's got two buffs onto the Dungeon Councilman, and patches is also a 2-2 as well.
He has a tough decision to make now. He can use the Councilman and the patches to trade in to his Councilman and get rid of it. Or he can deal with the Vampirizing. He cannot deal with both of them.
I think because you're going into turn 4, at this point, you take the Councilman. And then you can worry about Vampirizing. Soulfire could be there, but that's not game losing. Play, whereas a Doom Guard would be. And a bit of a whiff from Hoy as well.
Now it's Hoy with the poor hand.
And this is the thing, Old Boy can draw pretty badly, like he just did, but because he's got the Kellison buff, even drawing badly, that fire, the Fireblade is 2-3, right, rather than just a 1-2, so it didn't work out too bad for him. However, Hoy here, he can now only tap into a 1 drop, or Kellison.
Is going to be in an okay spot once he gets turn 5, but the problem is, so is Old Boy, and Old Boy's Despicable Dreadlord is going to do some serious damage. Also, when he gets turn 10, Old Boy will have cooldown to fall back on, though I don't think the Zoom Mirrors typically get to turn 5.
Might just reach a gold answer.
Ooh, that's a pretty good draw. Not only does it allow him to buff the council 3 times, it puts up 2 beefy points. You don't risk Hoy restocking. Less than ideal at the moment, and letting Hoy kind of reshuffle and start again isn't what Old Boy wants to be doing.
Look at those 4 cards. 2 of those you've got to throw away. They are 4 really impactful cards.
Is he playing 2 cards
well?
Right now, though?
I mean, potentially. Like, if he's looking at this board and saying, how do I actually get back into this game, is it just by getting the 2 card now?
I'm wondering about the Despicable Dreadlord into the Despicable Dreadlord. He's going to be dealing a lot of AoE damage if he goes for that combo. Top priority is getting that Bone Monster stick on turn 7.
Well, if that's your top priority, then no, not playing Doom Guard, because for all you know, you could just go for those away. But you are behind. And Doom Guard is one of the best ways to get back into this game.
Oh, that's a tough turn for Hoy. I would not like to be sitting in his chair right now.
I would quite happily have one of these chairs under my bottom. One awful turn that was for Hoy, but he is happy to go for a slightly weaker play, but probably the more sensible and less risque play.
Well, go down, it doesn't matter anymore. That Doom Guard is coming down every day of the week. Or is it? Hang on a second.
I don't know, you were pretty confident about that, but you seem to be going back on yourself.
I am going back on myself, because the Despicable Dreadlord allows Old Boy to deal with both minions whilst keeping one of those Sound Like Chain Gangs alive. That's actually pretty relevant.
I don't think you need to use the Doom Guard. I think Cairn is pretty good. I also think this Dreadlord is pretty good.
Okay, good with Cairn. I was well up from that. Maybe every day of the week, except once.
Yeah, Wednesday's not a good day for Doom Guards, I've heard. Especially when you were 2-0 down in the series and you've got the chance of winning 3-2, you know? I think naturally your heart and your go for that game, that's just Doom Guard, it's such an impactful play. It's the same point that you get. Instead, your hand just puts so much more pressure on. And it's something that sticks around.
Damn, both hands. Maybe this dice goes to the same. The second Despicable Dreadlord is essentially here, though. One of the Sound Like Chain Gangs just dies for 3, the other one gets traded into. Cairn gets weakened down to 4 health. It's pretty funny because now Old Boy's Despicable Dreadlord will deal with Boy's Despicable Dreadlord.
And he can also deal with the problem with his Cairn and still leave a 4-5 on the board. I mean, something that happens far too often in Zoo is that you are too precious of your gold art, so there will be some temptation at some point to play Doomguard before 10.
Well, Bowman doesn't play it anymore. But now he has to. Ah.
Well, that's not the end of the world. At least you can get some draws with it now.
Yeah.
But
I'm discarding
throwing away
two of your best cards in the deck, yeah, at this stage.
Again, probably not the end of the world. Goldan's not going to win him this game. However, a bone mare might get him back.
I agree. I still think it's unlikely that Hoyt gets to 2 and 10 without this bone mare going on. So, you know. Sanic Chain Gang will be helpful, but still no Kelicent. Just means over time, Hoyt falls further and further behind.
And I think now, yeah, one boy is going to play that Doom Guard. He doesn't care about Goldan either. Because that's not going to be what wins him the game. What's going to win him the game? Is actually just pressure here and now. He is so far ahead on the board, and he is so close to performing an absolutely remarkable
performance. Does make your deck better after it's played, significantly so. The amount of pressure that you deal skyrockets. Hoy can play everything except the bone mare if he doesn't mind discarding the bone mare. In fact, that may have to be his play now.
Yeah, that's a pretty back to the wall play, but. You're right, if you're going to stay alive in this game, Saranite Chain Gang does admit that does stop a little bit of damage coming towards you and allows you to keep ticking through your deck, but the longer this goes into just a top deck versus top deck situation, it's going to be more in favor of Old Boy because of Kelicent. That will be both bone mares tossed out of the window as well.
Yeah, but I don't believe you've seen a bone mare on Old Boy yet. And, as soon as he hits the bone mare onto the board, the game's over.
This game might be over already. Boy, it's such a commanding position.
Let's go back.
If you want to use just to its best ability, you could just get off the captain here with the Soulfire as well.
And one of his minions does survive, so it's Hoy's.
Old boy indeed. Will have the bone mare and has so much power on the board. He can taste victory now.
Yeah, I think for a little while he's been able to smell
it. Yeah, it was just a mere smell, a mere scent in his nostrils.
But now he can't.
Now it's like a delicious steak melting away on the tongue.
Hoy and Planet Arts and surrenders. Surrenders dramatic moves has just been forgotten.
So Hoy probably going to have to tap into some sort of answer here. Soulfire at least allows him to deal with the Doomguard, so still game on. It means he can deal with the Doomguard, get rid of it with the Celtic Captain, and then tap into something else that's not dead.
But what does he draw from here?
I mean, a can of his own might stick around a little bit. That was a little bit too late to the party.
Quite a lot.
10 damage available for Old Boy.
It's like 4 in the morning.
It's not even fashionably late. It's not even cool.
Yeah.
He's so late. The party's already finished. And I think it's just going through the motions for Old Boy as well. You just pile a hell of a lot of pressure onto this board. You've already seen bone mares being tossed away. You've already seen Goldan being tossed away as well. There is no way Hoy can come back from this game.
This has been an incredible performance from Old Boy with this music. I don't think anyone can deny that. Yes, he had a little bit of help from Prince Kalisa in a couple of the games there, but still, Evolution does it again. It's not quite a straight up sweep like what we've seen so far this week. But Old Boy showing that he can fight it out with the best of
them. Yeah, if I'm honest, it might even be more impressive than the 3-0 swing we've seen previously, because you have so much more pressure on you when you're in that situation. And even now, when the game is to come back, Old Boy still thinking about every last decision. How can I possibly lose this game? There is no way. Hoy concedes, and the 3-2 reverse sweep from Old Boy is absolutely remarkable. Every single player now on Evolution has won 3 games in a row at some point, and what a feeling that must be. Not just 3-0 victories, but they are also 3-0 in the standings as well.
three series played, three series swept. Although, as we said, Hannah Odd did get a few points on the board first. It just doesn't matter.